100 miles north of Reno lies the Black Rock Desert, site of the historic Applegate-Lassen Trail that was followed by fortune hunters during the California Gold Rush. Today, visitors here chase a different kind of glory.
So what are we doing today? Is this a research experiment, or are we recreating, or what's happening?
We're trying to be the first student group to launch a rocket into space.
And how high is that?
Space is internationally defined at 328,000 feet, known as the von Karman line.
So you're going to try and make history today?
Yes.
Now, we're not going to do it here, right? We go out that way?
No, so right now we're at the entrance of the playa. We're going to head out to our launch coordinates about 8 miles east into the desert.
Oh, this is going to be awesome. I'm following you, all right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Let's go.
All right.
Brandon Edelson and a team of students from the University of Southern California caravan to a remote section of the desert to launch their rocket. There's nervous excitement and anticipation in the air.
I'll set the stage for you. We're about 8 miles onto the playa. That's about halfway out here in the middle of nowhere. The attempt is to make the highest collegiate rocket launch in history, about 330,000 feet. You may be wondering, well, why bring a motorcycle? Because what goes up must come down, and they want to get it as quickly as possible.
The launch site has been pre-approved by the FAA to protect commercial airspace that uses this corridor. The first time the students tried to launch this rocket, the thermal protection system failed. After re-engineering the structure, they're giving it another shot.
Well, we've been here a couple of hours now. Everybody has divided into teams. You'll see them with different t-shirts on. And each team has a different station and a different responsibility. This particular one is where the rocket is being built. Let me see if I can get a word from, hey, Brandon. I know you got a lot going on. Sorry about that.
No worries.
Where do we stand? What's going on in here?
So right now we're doing a couple things. One, we've got our avionics team over here assembling our electronic systems to use and actually track the vehicle and get data on it while it flies. Here we have our recovery team assembling the parachute deployment system. We have two parachutes that allow the vehicle to come back and impact the ground safely while trying to minimize how far it can travel. So it's going so high, we need to make sure that it doesn't drift, you know, 20, 30 miles and land in Reno.
Ultimately, what's the big picture goal?
So a big picture, this flight is basically a proof of concept. What can a student group do on, at this level? What is accomplishable at this level? This vehicle can really do nothing but get to space. But it's a proof of technology that we've developed, and then we'll be able to use that to build a larger scale vehicle that actually insert payloads to suborbit, which is actually, there's a market for that. So this is also commercially viable as well.
The rocket was built by the students' own hands, and they only have a short window to complete the launch. There's a lot of tension building and months of work at stake.
Okay, this is a big moment because these teams have been out here since about 3-4 in the morning. It's now 4:20 in the afternoon, and they've been tinkering and they've been testing, and we're just on the verge of finding out of whether or not this is actually going to happen today.
So we're going to go for a launch. Avionics finalized tests, and we have nominal performance from all the units. There's an away team already in the foothills of Jordan, Jake, and Adam Rising. So the goal is we have a flight window till 9 p.m. Everyone's going to come back to the launch site. We'll have cars ready and stuff, recovery teams going, and then we are going to send her off. Regardless of what happens today, you should all be incredibly proud of yourselves. I don't think there's any time in Rocket Lab's history we've accomplished this much in a semester, and it is just absolutely humbling to have you all out here.
Brandon calls the FAA to confirm they're a go to launch the 155-pound rocket into space.
Some 13-plus hours after arriving here, everybody is dusty, but everybody is so excited because all the testing has been done, the FAA has been called, and now the rocket is on its way to the launch pad.
The sun is setting, and this is the moment of truth. The rocket is about to launch.
The launch of DCX-2 Tire Biter in 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, ignition.
The rocket appears to be going off course and something is not right. Suddenly, there's a plume of smoke spotted out on the playa.
So clearly something did not go as planned. The rocket did not make it into outer space, and they have now located it in another area of the playa. It was in flames, they put it out. There's a dejected feeling going on right now.
The students seem dazed, as if they don't believe what's happened. A portion of the smoking rocket lies on the ground and the nose cone is missing. After nearly a year of work, this is all that's left.
Well, as you can see, base camp is almost completely empty. Brandon and his team are out at the far end of the playa, and they are scouring the whole thing for the nose cone, for the avionics, and for answers of what went wrong today. It's a good reminder at the end of a long day that science is imperfect. It's trial and error. Just have to load it up and do it again next year.